Hello and welcome to Planet Coaster with me, Kevin Sawyer. And it's been a while, I know, guys. I haven't done a recording on this for quite some time. I've forgotten where we got to on this park. I've been playing sort of like building other parks elsewhere just to sort of get my head around how this game works. And I'm really getting my head around how it works now. So today's episode, hopefully, I'm going to try and build my own roller coaster. Yes, you heard me right. This could end with disaster straight off the get-go. I'm still enjoying the game. I just have everything else that I've been doing. I've got distracted, as you guys know me and love me well. I get distracted with anything new and shiny very quickly. But anyway, so let's try and build a coaster. So let's go to coasters and let's make our own custom coaster. I'm gonna try and go for a wooden one if I can. Steel coasters, hybrid coasters, wooden one. Cool. Right, I've just had a quick dot about before the episode. I want to try and incorporate this little valley if I can. So that is the plan. Right. I'm going to place it sort of here with the other coaster. I'm not going to go massively into detail of rocks or anything. I'm just going to build the basic coaster. And then I might do, if my imagination gets into gear, I might just sort of like, how do we rotate? It's been a while. I think it's Z, isn't it? Yeah, that's it. Z. And then we need to place it. We can raise and lower it if we wanted to as well. But I'm gonna perhaps place it roughly about here if I can. Or should I place it over here? No, I'm gonna place it over here. In fact, we're gonna just place that down quickly. Let's put it daylight all the time. So then we can see what we're doing. Let's increase the station size as well if we can. Because I know the bigger the station, the better. I've seen some pretty good builds on the Steam Workshop. One had like a dual station. I'd love to try and set that up if I can. And I may do. You never know. I might try it on a steel coaster, but just for this wooden one, I'm just gonna have it as a regular, just as a regular single coaster. Let's just get a bit longer steel. Right, that I think is probably pretty long enough. I don't know how many carts we can get into that. At least a couple, if anything. Right. Let's make it that. And then bring the I'll start off with the small dips first. Don't know if that's chain lift to the point I wanted it to as well. Hope so. Because I noticed there's something the other day. You've got to be very careful with this thing, because if you don't get it right, it can go wrong big time. So I'm going to start off with just a gentle one, go down, and then level out. Now, I won't confess to being a genius at making this either, and it's not going to be, overly impressive. So this is my first build of one. I've had a practice build on another one, and once I sort of get my head how this actually works, then jobs are good, and so to speak. Right, okay. So I'm gonna now level that back out again. And then I'm going to incorporate a bit of a turn. And then bring it actually round. Nope, it's not the way I want it to go. I want it to go this way. Now I know you can put like little helixes and stuff in. I might try doing that. Oh, that's the wrong way. Nope. That will work, I think. Will that work? Nope, that's going the opposite way I want it to go. So that's the way I want it to go. I don't know if that's going to work or not. Let's try it. Yeah, it worked. Cool. Now, I want to bring it back to normal straight. If I can. I notice as well, you've got to put auto tunneling on. If you don't put auto tunnel on, it's really difficult. The ground sort of like becomes very unforgiving very quickly. So let's try and raise that up a bit if we can. That's it. And then bring it round if I can. Was that limitations? Yeah, this looks like it's limitations. Let's try and straighten it out a bit again. Again, guys, if you find this a bit repetitive, let me know. I won't build another one or as a recording if you guys feel it's a bit repetitive. Again, I don't know whether to have it straighten up so quickly, because I noticed when on my first one, if you have it straighten up too quick, it breaks the coaster very quickly. The coaster becomes broken very quickly. So now let's incorporate a bend this way. So it kind of goes like that, then gently goes. Yeah, that's acceptable for me. Add that bit in. Now it should be sort of like still going quite fast. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to bend it this way and then bring in the curve as well. And I might try and raise it a little bit as well if I can. Whoa, that's a bit too much. That's better. Because my plan is, if I can just gently raise it back up and then bring it back down again. I might try and fit some rides in round this if I can. If it's possible, remotely possible. It's going to be a really long coaster though, that's the only thing. I must admit. And if I see time ticking by too much, I'll keep an eye on the time. I'll cut a little bit of the video and I'll just sort of get to the bit where it gets interesting, we're almost finished. What I've also found, if you can test it as well, I'll show you, restart the test off, even though the ride's not finished yet, you can start the test off. In fact, if we can get, I know it cuts out when the ride derails, but I've noticed if you're building a coaster and you're wanting to know if it's going to make it round, I think this is probably the best way to do it. Just do it in a little stage. Get to the point where you're unsure about it. See how it slows down quite considerably there. It does just make it over the hill. And you kill all your customers. Let's get out of that camera. Let's watch it set off again and just ploughing to nothingness. Meanwhile, I'm gonna just bring that. Up a bit more if I can. And then straighten it out. Now is that, yeah. Now I want it straight now. Can I undo that last bit? Whoa, yeah, it's because we haven't completed that bit. That looks about straight as it can be. Now is it? That's it. Add part. And then straighten this out a bit again. And then straighten this out. Add that. And then again, straighten it out. And then we're going to bring a dip in, I think, just to bring up some speed. So I'm going to just bring this down. And then bring it, if I can, back up again. Let's watch it, see if it makes it. Oh, see, it didn't make it round, look. Good we tested that. You see, there's a disaster straight away. So we need to edit this bit of the track if we can. Can we make this a chain lift? Train brakes. Right, okay, so we need to. If it is a smaller car, it might make it round. So I'm gonna come back and reduce the height for that. And then place. And then bring it a little bit round. Then place. Bring it a little bit round again. And this now slowly, gently bring the curve back in. Because like I said, if we don't, I've noticed it, the ride seems to break quite considerably, quite quickly. I think it was just, you know, you've got to plan these things into equation. Because if you don't, you're going to be suffering straight from the get-go. So stop the test. Let's try this test again, see if it's got enough momentum to go around. It might be just because the disc didn't have enough downhill on that. Now, see, this looks lowish to me. It might just make that round. See, that's digging itself into the ground. I don't want it to dig itself into the ground. I want it to just avoid the ground if we can get it to avoid the ground just for now. Bring it up a little hair whisker. Which is quite good because they've actually incorporated the physics, so it will allow for that. Now, will it make it? Yes, it makes it round. It's not getting much speed on there though, that's the downside. And that's another. Let's stop the test for now. Stop killing some more. Let's not kill any more crash test dummies. Let's give it some more speed. Not that much into the ground, I don't think. Is auto tunnel on? Yeah, auto tunnel is on. Now let's bring in another chain lift. Because I think we're going to need it for the next stage. Which is going to, I'm going to try and dip it into this mountain and back again if I can. I know I'm being ambitious, but and I'm wasting quite a lot of land by doing it, but hey ho. These are the tricks. This is how you learn as well. So I'm going to straighten this out now. I think that's quite high. I can remove the chain lift now. Can we block station train brakes? Friction brakes, drive tires, pushes trains along slowly. Nice. So we put some there, just at the top of there. Add one like that as well, and then I'm going to bring it round so it's facing towards that valley. That's it. And now it's when I'm going to try and get the dip involved if I can. I'm going to start the test and see if the train makes it. See, let's bring the downhill part of it in first. So. Start off nice and slow. Then step it. So it should start gather some momentum here. And now bring in a massive drop. I don't know if that's really unreasonable. It looks quite treacherous, that drop. Not as treacherous as that. I think that's probably the best option, because it doesn't look so bad then. Then bring it down. That's going to gather some quite a hair amount of speed there. Right, bring it level. We'll start to bring it a bit more level. And then bring it down a bit more as well. As you guys can see where I'm trying to go with this. And then I'm going to start incorporating the sloping on this next bit. Right. So start off with a little gentle curb. Oh, no, it's not where I want it to go. I want it to go, come up a little bit, and I need it to turn a bit more, and I'm going to bring it around a bit. Right. Let's start the test and see how that looks. Right. He's going off on his first section. Gets around here. I'm going to probably make the size of the carts a bit smaller anyway and test it again. Because I think, cause, you know, I wouldn't have this cart this long anyway. Because that's part of the mechanics of the game, as I was saying. It takes into consideration the weight of the carts. And, the, you know, it's quite a clever game, you know. And my hat goes off to the guys that developed this. For making this much level of detail into this game. Now, will he make it over that hill? Yes, he does. Cool. And it makes it to the chain lift section. Now, will it have enough momentum to carry it around? I think it might do, because it's still rolling, technically. There's no brakes applied yet. There they go. Wow, that's getting fast. And they're dead. Right, there's enough killing crash test dummies. I'm beginning to feel sorry for the poor guys. Right. Let's place this next bit in. Straighten it round a little bit. And I'll try and follow this valley through if I can. So let's bring this round a little bit. Add that in. Bring it level. Add that in. Let's try and turn it this way a bit now. And now let's try and move this around here. Because if we can use natural scenery, jobs are good, and so to speak. So place that bit in. Is that still at a tilt? Yeah, it's still at a tilt. So I need to start reducing the tilt now. Place that in. It's straight now, isn't it? Yeah, so if I can just massage it that way. That doesn't look too bad, actually. That does gently curve round. Bring it up. Oh, it's not straightened. I'm just trying to straighten this out now. There we go. And now I'm going to try and bring it up a bit as well. Because it's probably going to still be carrying some speed that's come round here. And I mean quite a fair amount of speed. So add that bit in. And then level it out. Bring it down again. Now, I'm wondering if we can incorporate Helix into this mountainside. Because wouldn't that be cool if we could? And then bring it back up. So that's what I'm going to try and do. I'm going to try and bring it round now. I don't know, actually. I'm going to put in a little straight section here. And now incorporate it round and up. Now, can we introduce this helix in? Oh, it's a shame we couldn't introduce it into the mountainside. Well, we still can. I don't know if that's going to be too much. So I'm going to start a test. This is going to be crazily long coaster, though. I could always come back the way we came, really. Just to save on space. I'm going to build that anyway, because we can always go back. Oops. I want to make that turn now. Not that way. This way. That's his max limitation. Can we straighten that out? We can. So I'm going to try and do that. I'm going to incorporate these rocks somehow. Ooh. Didn't want to do that. Want to try and bring that straight if I can. Yeah, straight into the rocks. Yeah. And then bring it straight. Let's see, let's dip into the rocks a bit. And then this is where it gets a bit tricky because you can try and see through rock, which is never great. Now, is that straight? No, it's at 11. Right, okay. Build that in. And now, can we build another helix going up? And is that enough of a slope for that to gain momentum for the next bit? Here it comes. Oh, it's coming quite a fair speed. Yeah. I don't know whether to put a brake section in this or not. Because that was quite a fair amount of speed that was coming through. You could hear it on like the tracks grinding as well. And I don't know if you should be having that grinding noise. I'm going to put this helix in anyway. That's going down, isn't it? Or is it? It's hard to see. That's going up. That's what I want to do. Right, I'm wondering if that's now going to be enough or too much. Because that was coming round that track at a fair old whiff of speed, wasn't it? To take some of the speed out of it. I might put some brake sections in, see how it reacts. Right, let's build this in. And let's curve this round now. Straighten it out again. Try and carry some of the speed through if we can. It might not be so bad once we reduce the size of the carts. Well, it made it up the... Yeah, that's quite cool. That's reduced quite a lot of its speed as well. And they're all dead. Poor old test dummies. Right. Right, guys. I'll pause it here. Because I don't want it dragging on too long for you guys. And I'll come back. Once I've get somewhere... to a near completed coaster, but I thought to start off just so you guys can see what's involved in making a coaster, and we'll come back and then do a little, maybe do a bit more work depending on time. I'll see you in a jiffy. Okay, guys, welcome back. Well, it seems like a blink of an eye for you. It's been about half hour twinkling with this and twinking it and twerking it and getting it to work. Because initially I had it with the five carts on, the full train load, but because I wanted to make some more, so there's more than one cart on here, I've had initially it worked with just all five, or the cart complete with all the carriages on as one. It just went around fine on my first go. The second go, it kind of sort of like it kind of pitted out in some areas, so I had to do some sort of tweaking around the track. But anyway, let's jump in it and then let's set it on test and jump in it at the same time. So let's jump in it. It won't go if I'm not got it on. So test and let's jump in it and let's enjoy the ride. Now this is where we become the test dummies. And hopefully this works. I've got nice white legs with pins in them. No arms to look. Here we go. I'd say this is like the warm up to the main event, these little dips. I've renamed the ride as well, Devil's Dive. So, rather than the standard name. That's quite a cool shot there. Just looking around, you can see the mountains in the distance there. Here we go. Gonna pick up some speed now. Oops. Go back to camera. Cinematic view. Whee! This is where I had a few problems on this bit of the track. It kept on sort of like with these little carriages on it. It kept on pittering out and then rolling back on itself. So I had to sort of make some little mini dips. It kind of slows down to a little crawl here, but I think that's kind of fortuitous because it sort of slows it down, ready for the next bit, the chain lift. And a problem on this bit as well. It kind of almost lost all its momentum on that hill. So I had to do some sort of like working on that bit. And this bit was a bit of a pain at the end as well. So they wouldn't make it all the way around. But that is it. So let's stop the testing. So the max speed I've got on this ride is up to 50 miles an hour, I think, on it, roughly. So that's I'm going to show you guys how to make a quick priority queue as well. I don't know if we've got, have we got an information booth? I'll quickly build that by the entrance. I think we might have one. That's where they come in. That's just gifts, isn't it? So I'm going to put one in there somewhere. I think there's some room around here. Or is there one already open? That's the ATM. That's the toilet. So I'm going to put the, if I can, put it here. Shops and facilities. Information. Planet Coaster information. I'll stick it by this little shop here, I think. If I can. So, can we minimise this? Because it's a bit annoying, this box. Oh, not without getting rid of the whole thing. Try that again. Shops and facilities. Can I minimise this? Yes, I can. That's it. That's helpful. That's better. Right. Is that information? Yeah. Right. Rotate. You might be asking, why am I putting in... Well, if we go into the budget side of it, information, priority pass. Right, I'm going to set that initially because I've only got the one ride with a priority pass, so I'm going to set that down to £5. Now you might be wondering, for you guys that not play this game, why am I doing this? Because you can actually build priority lanes whilst playing on sort of getting my head around the game. I discovered this, and I'll show you how you do that. I'm gonna probably do it off on this one if I can. Actually, probably can't do it on this one because the way I'd have to restructure the queue path for that if I wanted to do it that way. That one's not too busy at the moment anyway, but this one I've made it so I can place in, hopefully. So what you do is you enable priority pass and then you place your little entrance. It's a bit tricky, admittedly, and then place your exit. Again, you need to leave a little bit of space for it to fit. As I say, it's going to be a bit tricky. Yeah, as I thought it might be. Come on. Okay, might have to just do some maintenance on it. Path. Right, hang on. Let's get rid of that. Path. Queue path. How do we delete the path? Delete path. Here. Right. Now it's putting the path back in. No, I don't want to connect it. No. No. Okay, delete some more of that path. Stop that from doing that. Hopefully. Put the path back in. And then if I bring it down now, that's obstructed. Nice. Hang on, let's delete that bit of path. I don't think we need it that long. Can I now... If I, as long as I can place that in... Oh, gonna be tricky. Connect. Entrance path. Right. Now I'm gonna bring it down. Hopefully that's enough. I think I've just done exactly what I just did before. Hopefully not. That's it, it's a bit crooked, but it works. Now, place priority exit. It should now, hopefully, come on. There we go. Get there in the end. Just on the edge. Right, okay. Now, connect that with some pathfinder. I'm going to make it a different colour. Oops. Undo that then. Why are you doing that? Undo. Why are you going at such an odd angle? Nope. Undo. Undo. Won't let me. That's it. Like that. Cool, got there in the end. But as you can see, you can literally skip the queue. If there's a massive queue here and you've bought a priority pass, you can go into here and get a priority and literally get in front of the other. So that's the plan. Right, that's now we've tested it, we can now officially actually open it. Let's make sure the settings, not half load, full load. Thank you. Minimum wait time, maximum wait time. I'm going to set that down to... yeah, leave it as is, actually. Maximum departure. I'm going to round up to 4 seconds. Yeah, they're probably going to send them off empty, possibly, just because that's the way they work. But now I've got that built roller coaster, let's do some marketing quickly, just to encourage some more people into the park, because we haven't got many. Where's the marketing? Park management. Marketing. Let's... attracts adults and groups, and then let's do a viral video, online viral videos, attracts more teenagers. Cool. So that, oh, we've got a customer, we've got someone coming in already. We've got a couple of people that, and in fact, it's this doing this. I know this is why they do this now in parks. It's a kind of queuing, sort of like karma. It stops everyone running into the. Onto the ride at once. It slowly trickles them in. Oh, it's quite popular. Quite a few people are getting on it now. They're all excited about it now. They've seen this new ride and they're like, wow, let's have a go on a new ride. I might put some more rides around here actually, because it seems a bit sparse. If I can put a ride between here and here, then jobs are good, and I just want to wait and see the first lot getting on there and having fun. Let's change the camera. Oh, they're off on the way. Okay, it's not fully loaded, but at least it gets it away. Let's see the reaction on their faces if we can. Oh, yeah, they're looking happy still. Whee! Oh! They're screaming. Oh. She still looks happy. Whee! They still look happy, that's the main thing. She's got like a t-shirt on, looks like she's bought a t-shirt maybe from the shop. Wow, that's quite a dip. It's not a massive dip like I have done in the past. They don't look well now. Must have put some lighting in there, I suspect. Oh. They're still happy though. They're like that. It's just like trying to keep front. That guy at the back, he's just looking chilled. He's like, yeah, this is all in a day's work for me, mate. I'm a coaster rider. That's all I do all day long. Whee! That's a bit anticlimactic, I know, guys, but. Seems more uphill than downhill, admittedly, but this is where I wanted this to go. And it's got that massive dip there. I should have put some dips between there and there, really, but I didn't want to sort of like overdo it. And this is the double helix, so it goes in a helix down and then a helix up. And they crash straight into the back of the other car. That's the only problem, is they get held up and waiting for other customers to jump on. But I think that more or less concludes the episode, guys. I'll quickly put shopping, another ride in here somewhere. That's because we've got thrill rides going on here. Let's put in another thrill ride along here. Let's put this in. I put a priority pass for this one as well, actually. Can I move that? I want to move it so you can see it. There we go. They're all coming rushing for that old roller coaster now, look. Put the place entrance in. I'm going to place the entrance round about here. And then place the exit around about here. And then I'm going to put another priority pass in. I'm going to make that kind of like space age kind of stuff. I quite like that. Oops. Undo that last one because it's not let me. Oops. Not my finest work, I must admit, but it doesn't matter as long as it acts to slow them from running in. There we go. Cool. And then I put a priority one in a bit, but as I said, guys, I'll leave it at that. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Let's quickly see what their thoughts were. I think these guys just come off of it. Really cheap tickets, yeah. Good. They've already enjoyed that then. That's going to get popular, I can see. That's a full load, more or less. Them guys run quick enough. There we go. They're on. That should set off on its way eventually. Well, that's short of two. But that'll get more and more popular. But anyway, guys, as I said, again, I'll leave it there. Hope you guys enjoyed the episode. If you did, please don't forget to like. It helps me out a lot. And if you know anyone else that might also enjoy watching the episode, again, guys, helps me out a lot. And I don't mind you guys sharing, so please feel free to share. And if you're new to my channel or see future episodes of this or anything else that I'm working on, please don't forget to subscribe. I'll see you in the next one. TTFN.